अस्सलाम वालेकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहु। वेलकम यू ऑल द स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास 11 इन द लेक्चर ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एज वी हैव गोइंग ऑन टू चैप्टर नंबर 7 दैट इज मॉडर्न पीरियोडिक टेबल। दिस इज आवर 11th लेक्चर फॉर द सेम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी पीरियोडिक trends in physical properties of elements in the modern periodic table. Many physical properties of element such as melting point, boiling point and density, so periodicity. Earlier I have explained what is the meaning of periodicity. Okay, the one which is getting repeated after a regular interval of time and period. So here in modern periodic table, the properties of the element will show similarity after a regular interval of time and space. So here in this section, we are going to consider the periodic trends in some of the physical properties with reference to atomic radius, ionic radius, ionization enthalpy, electron gain enthalpy, and electronegativity. Each of these topics we are going to study in detail. Today in this lecture we are going to study only physical properties of elements with reference to atomic radius and ionic radius. So here student, let's start. First, atomic radius. You're familiar with the word radius. What is radius? We are making a circle. In the circle, we are giving some point at the center. Okay, so the distance from the center to the outer layer of the circle, that is your radius. Okay, so here similarly in an atom, at the center what is present? At the center nucleus is present. So the distance from the nucleus to the outermost shell, the distance from the nucleus to the outermost shell, as we know there are various number of shell in an atom depending upon its atomic number, that is how much electron it contain, and on the basis of that the electron will enter in the respective shell. So the distance from the nucleus to the outermost shell is your atomic radius. We have learned in chapter number 4 that the quantum mechanical model of an atom, what does it describe? The quantum mechanical model of an atom describe the extra nuclear part of an atom as the electron cloud. Your nuclear part is there, that is your nucleus. In the nucleus, proton and neutron is present. Around the nucleus, various shells are present. In those shells, electrons are present. Fine. Depending upon its atomic number, the numbers of electron will present, and that numbers of electron will be occupied with respect to their shell. Okay, they will be filled with respect to their shell. As a direct amplification of this, the atom has no definite boundary. It doesn't have a boundary. Suppose in the first period elements, the elements of the first period will contain one number of shell, while the elements of the third period will contain three numbers of shell. So the atom has no definite boundary. The atomic size or atomic radius. What atomic size? What is the size of an atom or the atomic radius? Therefore, can be estimated from the internuclear distance under different circumstances. For the first period element, it is different to calculate or estimate the internuclear distance, while for the third period or the fifth period element, it is different to estimate the internuclear distance. Fine. So it is different for different element. In the case of non-metal, what about non-metal? Leaving behind noble gas, the atom of an element are bonded to each other by covalent bond. So your student, the non-metal elements leaving behind noble gas, the atoms are linked together, they are bond to each other by covalent bond. What is covalent bond? A bond is formed between an element by sharing of an electron. A bond formed between an element by sharing of electron. You have been studied this in chapter number 5. If not, then what is covalent bond? A bond formed between an elements by sharing of electron. So bond length of a single bond is taken as sum of radii of two single bonded atoms. The bond length between these elements, we are going to study the example for the same. Just remember here, the bond length of a single bond, that is your covalent bond, is taken as sum of radii of single bonded atom. The radius of one bonded atom and the radius of the another bonded atom, add it, you will get the length of a single bond. This is nothing but covalent radius of the atom. It is your covalent radius of the atom. Let's see an example over here. As we see in diamond, the bond length is 154 pm. This is your bond length, okay, between carbon and carbon in diamond. Just divide this value by 2. 154 divided by 2, you will get the value 77. This is nothing but the atomic radius of carbon. Atomic radius of carbon in diamond. Similarly, another example over here, bond length of Cl in Cl2. The bond length between chlorine and chlorine in Cl2 is measured as 198 pm. Divide 198 pm by 2, you will get the atomic radius of chlorine, which is 99 pm. Fine. Chlorine, the bond length in Cl between Cl and Cl is 198 divided by 2. You will get the atomic radius, that is your 99 pm. Let's see over here, atomic radius of Be, beryllium. You see, the bond length between beryllium and beryllium is 224 pm. So divided by 2, you will get the value. See, this is your one beryllium atom, this is your another beryllium atom. So the distance from one nucleus to the another, that is your bond length between beryllium and beryllium, is your 224 pm. Divide this value by 2, you will get the value 112 pm. This is nothing but the atomic radius of beryllium, that is your 112 pm. Similarly, we have seen the example that chlorine, the bond length between chlorine and chlorine is 198 pm. Divide this value by 2, you will get the atomic radius of chlorine, that is 99 pm. In this way, you can estimate the atomic radius of metal and non-metal. Here, student, in the case of metal, distance between the adjacent atom in metallic sample is measured. Just we are supposed to take one half of this distance as metallic radius. Thus, atomic radius is nothing but one half of the internuclear distance between the nucleus. What is the distance divided by 2? Between whom? Between two adjacent atoms. Here you see one adjacent atom, one atom of beryllium, another atom of beryllium. We are taking the internuclear distance between them, the distance between the two nucleus. Okay, and we are dividing it by 2. So atomic radius is nothing but 1/2 of the internuclear distance between two adjacent atoms of a metal or two single bonded atoms of a non-metal. Hence, student, you have understood what is atomic radius. Atomic radius is nothing but it is the 1/2 of the internuclear distance between two adjacent atoms of a metal or two single bonded atoms of a non-metal. So here we have completed with the topic atomic radius. You see in the table there is some atomic radius of some of the elements have been given. As you see in second period, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. Fine. While in the third period, you see sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. This is the second period elements, while this is the third period elements. What do you see over here? Just see in the second period. What do you observe? From the table, you see that atomic radius of the elements is been decreasing. While down the group, in the first group, you see lithium, sodium, potassium, and so on elements, the atomic radius of the element is been increasing. You see, across the period, the value of lithium is 152, then for beryllium 111, then A for boron 88, and so on. The value from 88, it has been decreasing to 74, 77, 74, 66, 66. So here the atomic radius has been decreasing across the period. While it is increasing, see in the lithium it is 152, then in sodium it is 186, then in potassium it is 231, so on. The value down the group, it has been increasing. So here, student, from the table, it has been clear that atomic radius decreases across a period. We have taken till group 17 and it has been increasing down the group. Why? Because greater the effective nuclear charge, stronger is attraction of the nucleus for the outer electron and smaller is the atomic radii. In the period, you say the number of shell is been same. The number of shells has been same. The element lithium will have 2 number of shell. The carbon will having 2 number of shell. But here you see the atomic number is increasing. As the atomic number is increasing, number of proton is increasing. And the number of electron is also increasing, but the number of electron is been entering in the same shell. So the effective nuclear charge will also be increasing. As greater the effective nuclear charge, stronger will be the attraction of the nucleus for the electron and for the outer electron, and smaller will be the atomic radius. As you see, you take a magnet. Take a small piece of magnet and take a little bit piece of magnet. I'm just giving an example, okay? Yes, what do you observe? Smaller piece of magnet will attract little bit of iron filling, while the greater part of magnet will attract more iron filling. So here also, student, as the nuclear charge is getting stronger, attraction between the nucleus and the outer electron will also be getting stronger, and due to this there will be decrease in atomic radius across the period. So here, as we move across the period, screening effect caused by the core elements remain the same. On the other hand, effective nuclear charge goes on increasing. So the valence electron are therefore more tightly bound, and in turn the atomic radius goes on decreasing along a period. While the effective nuclear charge decreases and shielding effect increases down a group. We have been studied what is effective nuclear charge, what is shielding effect in detail in our previous lecture. So as we are moving down the group, you see lithium containing 2 number of shell, sodium containing 3 number of shell, potassium containing 4 number of shell, and so on. As here the atomic number is increasing, number of proton is increasing, number of electron is increasing, but here the number of shell is also being increases. The electron will enter into the new shell. Fine, number of shell is increasing. So here, as the number of shell is increasing, the effective nuclear charge will goes on decreasing. Why? The distance from the nucleus to the outermost shell is being increasing. So the effective nuclear charge will goes on decreasing, and due to which shielding effect will increases down a group. So the valence electron are thus held by weaker attractive force. The valence electron means the outer electron, they have held by weaker attractive force, and so on, the atomic radius increasing down the group. So remember, your student, across the period effective nuclear charge increases and shielding effect decreases, due to which the atomic radius is being decreases. While down the group, the effective nuclear charge increases and the effective nuclear charge decreases and shielding effect increases, due to which atomic radius increases down the group. Let's move forward towards our next topic, that is your ionic radii. An atom forms a positively charged ion. Your atom is there, it will be getting converted into positively charged on the removal of one or more electron. Whereas a negatively charged ion is formed with gain of one or more electron. When an atom, any of the atoms, suppose sodium is there, its atomic number is 11. When it gives an electron, it will be getting converted into Na plus. Fine. So it will be getting converted into cations. Any atom which gives an electron, it will be getting converted into positive charge, that is your cations. While any atom which gain an electron, it will be getting converted into anions, and it will carry negative charge. So your measurement of distance between neighboring cations and anions in ionic crystal have been used successfully, useful for estimation of ionic radii. So here the distance between neighboring cations and anions is nothing but your ionic radii. The ionic radii show the trends as of atomic radii. What is happening across the period? Across the period, atomic radii is been decreasing. Similarly, ionic radii will also be in decreases across the period, while it is been increasing down the group. A cation is smaller than the atom from which it is formed. Obviously, a cation gives one electron. If it gives one electron, suppose sodium, its atomic number is 11. It containing 11 number of electron. When it get converted into Na plus, it means it has given one electron. So here the number of electron will be decreases. From 11, it has been converted into 10. Fine, because it contains fewer electron than atom. So here a cation is smaller than the atom from which it is formed. Why? Because it contains fewer electron than atom. So the nuclear charge is the same. The nuclear charge will be same. It will contain 11 number of proton. As a result, the shielding effect is less and effective nuclear charge is large within a cations. Okay. While in an anion, it contains larger radius than the corresponding atom. Why? Because it will gain more number of electron. Suppose Cl minus, that is your chlorine. Chlorine, it carries negative charge. It has been converted into anions. It will grab one electron. Fine. Atomic number of chlorine is 17. When it has been converted into Cl minus, it will gain one electron, and it at a numbers of electron will be 18. This additional electron result in increased electron repulsion. Obviously, if the numbers of electron will be increases, it will result in increased electron repulsion and decreases effective nuclear charge. And nuclear charge will decreases as the number of proton is same, but the number of electron here it has been in an anion, it has been increases. So in turn, it increases the size of an anions. Some atom anions contain. Here we see that some atom anions contain the same number of electron, and they are known as isoelectronic species. These atoms will contain their respective number of proton, but here these atoms will contain, atoms or ions will contain the same number of electron. These atoms or ions are known as isoelectronic species. You have been studied in chapter number 4. Here the actual nuclear charge of the isoelectronic species is, however, different. The radius of isoelectronic species vary according to actual nuclear charge. What is its actual number of proton? What is its atomic number? Depending upon it will contain the number of proton. Larger nuclear charge exert greater attraction for the electron, and the radius of that isoelectronic species becomes smaller. Obviously, if the nuclear charge will be more, attraction between the nucleus and the electron will be more, and so on, the radius of that isoelectronic species becomes smaller. For example, fluorine, you see fluorine, it atomic number is 9. It will contain 9 number of proton and 9 number of what? 9 number of It will contain 9 number of electron, but here the fluorine has been converted into F minus, that is your anions. So one of the electron will be added in fluorine atom. So it will contain how many number of electron? It will contain 10 number of electron. Similarly, for sodium, atomic number is 11. It will contain 11 number of electron, but it here the sodium has been converted into cations, Na plus. So again, it will lose one electron, it will be converted into 10 electron. So here fluorine and sodium, fluorine minus, fluorine anions and sodium cations both have 10 electrons. So their radius are 133 pm and 98 pm respectively. As the nuclear charge of fluorine is plus 9, and for that sodium is plus 11, whose nuclear charge is more? The nuclear charge of sodium is more as compared to fluorine. So which is smaller than that of sodium? Fine. The nuclear charge of F minus is plus 9, while that of sodium is plus 11. So the nuclear charge of fluorine anions is smaller than that of nuclear charge of sodium cations, which is 11. Here, student, one numerical for you. Identify the species having larger radius from the following pairs. First one is your Na and Na plus sodium cations. It carries one charge. The nuclear charge will be the same in Na and Na plus. Plus Na plus has less number of electron and less number of occupied shell. There will be 2 shell in Na plus, while 3 shell in Na. Fine. You see, atomic number of sodium is 11. Its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Fine. This is the atomic number of sodium. While the atomic number, that is, this is the electronic configuration of sodium. That is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. So, your student, the electronic configuration of sodium is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1, while that of Na plus will be changed to 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. 3s1 will be not be 10 because here it will contain 10 number of electrons. So, 2 shell in Na plus while 3 shell in Na. So, the radius of Na will be large as compared to Na plus. Okay, why? Because the nuclear charge in Na plus will be more as compared to that of the nuclear charge will be same, but the attraction will be more in Na plus and then that in Na. So the radius of Na will be large. Another example, Na plus and Mg2 plus. Okay, Na plus and Mg2 plus both are isoelectronic species, means they will contain the same number of electron. Mg2 plus has larger nuclear charge than Na plus. Why? Because the atomic number for sodium it is 11, for magnesium it is 12. Fine. So the nuclear charge, the number of proton in magnesium is more as compared to Na. Hence the nuclear charge will be more for Mg than Na. So Na has larger nucleus, Na plus will be having larger nucleus as compared to Mg2 plus. In this way you can find out any of the species which contain larger nucleus or which contain the smaller nucleus, larger radius or the smaller radius. Fine. So in this way we can calculate the radius of an atom and compare the radius of different atoms. So here student, we have completed today's lecture. Hope you have understood. Take care, study well, do your best students. Thank you.